And welcome back here to WorldChallengeTV.com. My name is Jeff Leppard. Jeremy Shaw, join me in the booth as we get set to start round number one of the Pirelli World Challenge Nissan Grand Prix of Texas presented by Motul for our GTS category. And Jeremy, 20 cars set to take the green when the lights go out here in the GTS class. And a little changes for GTS this year, as now they have their own standalone race.
Yeah, very exciting for these teams and drivers here to be battling not only amongst themselves, but now for the overall honors as well. And as we can see from the number of manufacturers involved in this class, it's populated by, you know, all the major manufacturers effectively, but particularly it's geared towards the muscle cars. And we have Corvettes, we have Chevrolet Camaros, but beating them all to the pole was the Aston Martin Vantage V8 of Chris Wilson.
Yeah, he sure did, stepping in for his sick really teammate that they run in the other series, the Continental Series. Max Wilson, I believe.
Oh, Max Riddle, yes.
Max Riddle, I apologize. Yeah, Max Riddle and Chris Wilson, the teammates, they're running they've run together this car for a long time, and Chris was in the car all day yesterday.
And they ran this very same car at the 3-hour race at Daytona in January, but a lot of different regulation changes between the two series. They've got much more aerodynamics on this car here, different tires, of course, as well. And speaking to Chris Wilson just a little while ago, who's a former Skip Barber racing instructor, massive amount of experience. It's only his third ever World Challenge race, did a couple about 15 years ago. But loving it now, putting this car on the pole. Yeah, his teammate has mononucleosis. He picked it up a week or so ago, so he's not feeling well enough to be here. And at the last minute, Chris Wilson gets the call.
All these drivers with their excuses, you know. No,
it's always yeah, mono's one a good another, one, right? I guess, yeah.
Color notables in the field, and we'll go ahead and run through the top 10 of our grid. We mentioned Chris Wilson. Starting on the outside of the pole is the driver of that Pitcher Cars East Rahegan Racing Ford Mustang Boss 302, Dean Martin from Westland, Michigan. Mark Wilkins, championship contender there last year, looking for a lot of the same this year, that Kia Motors America, Kia Optima, starting in third. Andrew Aquilante is the juggernaut that is Phoenix Performance, returns to Pirelli World Challenge, and the Calvert Dynamics Phoenix Performance Ford Mustang starts in fourth. Andy Lee, the youngster, we talk about him in that Best IT Crown 7, Bob Bondurant Camaro, he'll start in the fifth place. Jack Baldwin, boy, there's a two different terms of experience and racing side-by-side with Jack Baldwin in that Reset MD Porsche Cayman. Kurt Resitano, the shot boy from Phoenixville, Pennsylvania, in that Phoenix Performance Ford Mustang, he'll start in seventh. Derek DeBoer out of Ashland, Oregon, the team car to that Aston Martin Vantage GT4 with BRM chronographs on the side of that car, he'll start in eighth. Ben Klukas, a newcomer to the Kia Motors America Kia Optima team, takes over that seat from Nicky Onsen, starts in ninth. And Luda Giordani out of Plano, Texas, four-time Pirelli World Challenge champion in his LG Motorsports in an Aston Martin Vantage GT4, will start 10th.
Yeah, great to see Lou Giolotti back in the series, and so much enthusiasm. He finally admitted to me today he's been lying about his age for quite a long period of time. He finally confesses to being 65. For somebody who's 65, his level of enthusiasm, he and Jack Baldwin, I mean, they're both a similar age. Jack's a little bit older, actually, but it's great to see that enthusiasm. And Lou, having been out of the sport really for a couple of years, has done a few sort of one-off drives over in recent years, but not lately, and he's absolutely loving driving this Aston Martin V8 Vantage.
Yeah, I don't think I can count into triple digits to see the race experience with Lou Giolotti and Jack Baldwin combined, but hey, we're being recorded. I better be careful what I say. Starting 11th spot, Jack Roush Jr. returns to Pirelli World Challenge competition for the second year in that Roush Performance Ford Mustang Boss 302. Michael Cooper, how about this? 2011 Touring Car Champion in that Mazda Speed 3 car that he ran way back when. You think about Michael Cooper, been out of the seat for a couple years, gets the nod to replace Tony Gapel's team at Black Dog Speed Shop, and two-time champion Lawson Ascherbach. Those are some big shoes to fill.
Absolutely. What a great opportunity for Michael Cooper, and he's determined to take this opportunity with both hands. You know, that's pretty much a brand new car this year. It looks pretty much the same as last year, but underneath the hood, a lot of changes. Completely different engine. It's the LS5 7-litre V8 engine in that car, and a lot of stock components, carbon ceramic brakes, 19-inch wheels, and a lot of stock components. So it's kind of a new car, even though the car looks similar, a Chevrolet, but running a new Z28 bodywork. And so it's in terms of the balance of performance, you know, the officials don't really know where that car stands up yet. So perhaps a little bit conservative on that car for the first weekend, but they've had both he and Tony Gapel's, the cars have been running well.
Dan Martinson will start in the 13th place in the Gear Tie Night Eyes Ford Mustang Boss 302 from Capaldi Racing, who's actually got a joint relationship now with Roush Performance, so all four of those Mustangs all competing under one banner. Tony Gapel will start in the 14th place, the team owner at the Black Dog Speed Shop. He's also in that Chevy Z28. Mark Clinton gets his own program this year from Lone Tree, Colorado, the Schwamp Invisible Glass Premier Copier Aston Martin Vantage GC4 from Clinton Performance Racing. It's good to say that with your own name and your own team. Preston Calvert, the Calvert Dynamics Phoenix Performance Ford Mustang Boss 302, no less than 3 Mustangs competing in GTS and 6 cars all weekend for that Phoenix Performance. He'll start in 16th. Buzz McCall from Boca Raton, Florida. Ironic story I heard about Buzz McCall in that Reset MDA Porsche Cayman starting in the 17th position. He was actually Jack Baldwin's team owner back in the Trans Am Series. So we just got the command to start engines down there on the pre-grid. Look at Nick Asayan. He steps into his third different make of car in 3 years, driving that Travel Clean Ford Motorsports Derma 3 Ford Mustang Boss 302 from Capaldi Racing. Jeff Reeves, the Shadow Works Best IT Chevy Camaro, starts in the 19th, and it's his old car from last year, but it's been updated with those Z28 components like you mentioned, so it's not a Z28 chassis, but we all know the metal is just the metal. It's everything that gets bolted onto that metal that makes the car. And Vesco Kozaroff, rounding out your top 20, unfortunately had an engine change, blew the motor up. They could not get that car ready in time. That car's been withdrawn. So 19 cars set to go with the lights out, 50 minutes till we... go for round number one and see how all this plays out, Jeremy.
Yes, it's a shame we won't see that Nissan in 20th place there take the start. But Jeff Reeves also had some problems in qualifying this morning in that number 40 Shadowworks Chevrolet Camaro. And so he's going to be starting at the back as well, along there, as you were just saying, with Nick Asayan, who the last round of last series was on the podium. I think both he won the final race of last year, Nick Asayan, and now he finds himself back in 18th position on the starting grid.
Yeah, not where he wanted to be there, and I'm sure he's going to want to work his way on up. Won the race at Miller Motorsports Park in an Aston Martin Vantage GT4, getting that second win. It was for Nick Asayan. So a lot of great things happening here at the track at Circuit of the Americas. The season opener for the Pirelli World Challenge. Once again, the Nissan Grand Prix of Texas presented by Motul. And it's been such a great race here. 7 classes of the Pirelli World Challenge will be joined live for every race here, all 7 races this weekend at world-challengetv.com. Thank you so much for everybody that's participating. If you haven't had a chance to make it out to this great track here at Circuit of the Americas, put this on a bucket list. This is a track that guys want to come see. Gals love to go because the Austin environment here, this is a great place to be.
It certainly is, and there's a good lineup of cars here. It's temperatures warmed up a little bit from yesterday, certainly, so a lot more hospitable conditions out there. Conditions are actually pretty good for racing right now. It's probably what, high 50s or low 60s, and the track is in extremely good shape. We've even seen some shadows there on the grid. There's sun beginning to poke its way through. That's always got to be good news. But yeah, we're in for an exciting 50-minute race, which will be getting underway in just a few minutes.
So Pirelli storylines going into this race. We got to think about the atmosphere that GTS landscape is changing with this standalone event. That's got to be a huge story for that. And the unknowns going into this. A lot of new faces, some new cars coming in. How's that going to transpire? Your Motul race analysis. We're here at Circuit of the Americas. It's a 20-turn permanent road course, 3.4 miles long. And we're set up for 50-minute sprint race here. Lights go out, we go green for a solid 50 minutes. It's going to be exciting around this course. Cars are getting ready to roll off. We'll all be led by that brand new Cadillac ATS-V pace car. Of course, Cadillac, our official pace car, and providing that new ATS-V pre-production models. They look great. I cannot wait. And there's a great shot of that Cadillac ATS-V. I'm in the market for a new car. Can't afford a new car, but I'm always in the market for a new one. And that Cadillac ATS-V seems to fit my taste very nicely. Just does not fit my budget.
No, maybe not quite, but it is a gorgeous looking car, I must admit. And it's good to see it leading the field here. They come out onto the now sunshine. It's great to see the sunshine finally poking through here. You know, yesterday was nice and sunny, but very, very cold. Today we had a bit of cloud cover and warmer temperatures, and now we've got the sun out to join us as well. Just in time for the start of the race.
Drivers will come out here for their, we call this the reconnaissance lap, led by that Cadillac Cadillac ATS-V. Well, I got to put a dollar in the CTS ATS jar. So that's an ATS-V, just a beautiful car. Don Harpel driving that car is our pace car driver. There is the Cadillac Escalade, the official safety vehicle of the Pirelli World Challenge. Cadillac doing our pace car and safety vehicle. Dick Lupatina and Bob Schaefer behind the wheel of that car. It's one of those things that's better to have it and not need it than it is to need it and not have it.
That's exactly right. And it was a brand new Cadillac, wasn't it, last year at Detroit, the safety car, and it was involved in an incident. It wasn't on the racetrack.
Yeah, absolutely. It was an unfortunate thing, but we're back with that all-brand-new 2015 Cadillac Escalade. Just a beautiful thing, and we appreciate all that Cadillac does for the Pirelli World Challenge and racing and motorsports in general. Great partner to be with Pirelli World Challenge. You see a lot of the drivers getting those Pirelli P0 tires warmed up, coming around this beautiful facility once here at COTA Circuit of the Americas. Nicknamed COTA is what we call it. That big tower up to the top. You've been up to the top of that tower, Jeremy?
Never have. No, I haven't. I must admit.
I think we need to go up there. I think we'll have to go. Maybe we can call a race from up there. That'd be pretty cool.
That would be cool.
Live at worldchallengetv.com from the top of the tower there at Circuit of the Americas. Couldn't think of a better place. Here's that big, long straightaway down from turn number 11 down to turn number 12. In the media rides on Thursday, I got a chance to take out one of the Nissan GTRs for the media ride. Appreciate Nissan, of course, our title sponsor of the race weekend, and we were just touching 155 miles an hour right before we hit the braking zone there. So that was it tells you what these cars should be going a lot faster than I was going in that little streetcar Nissan GTR.
Absolutely right. The average speed of the pole position here was tick over 90 miles an hour. That's the average, and let's not forget there's a couple of hairpin corners here and some other slow corners as well. So to get an average of 90 miles an hour in these basically, well, sort of production-based cars, is impressive. But this is going to be a real battle here. We've got five manufacturers involved in the race. Nissan, unfortunately, will not start the Nissan Skullcandy entry of Vesco Kozarov has been pulled out after that problem yesterday. But five other manufacturers are going to be going at it, hammer and tongs.
Yeah, there they go, riding around in that Escalade there. Cars will come down here onto the front stretch, take their position for the standing start. And remember, when the lights go on, revs will come up. Lights go out, we go racing. There's a good shot of Lou Gelati in his LG Motorsports Aston Martin Vantage GT4. Was doing double duty here in his GT3 as well, but unfortunately that car is having problems. We will not see Lou Gelati running double duty here this weekend.
No, that's right. That car was very much new to the team, and they had some electrical problems in that car over on the test day and again yesterday morning, so elected not to run that car and concentrate on the GT4 car for this weekend. And talking to Lou just before the start of the race an hour or so ago, he was saying they did have a little bit of problem with the gearbox on the car. This car has come from Portugal, actually, he sourced this GT4 Aston Martin Vantage. And they told him when he bought the car, he said the gearbox is getting close to needing a rebuild. But he said, well, hopefully we can get through this weekend. He's already planned to have a new gearbox in the car for the St. Petersburg the next round in a few weeks' time. But the engine, it's a brand new engine from ProDrive in the UK. And Lou Gelati is excited to get his phase 118 of his racing career back underway.
Yeah, that's great. And, you know, four-time champion, the Pirelli World Challenge, over 115 starts. Just one of the great ambassadors of Pirelli World Challenge. Great to have him. Cars are lined up. We'll get him staged. We get that green flag from Wick Wrong on the back of the grid. Usually that starts the process. We'll get the countdown. You'll see the five-second board. And that's 5 seconds till the process starts, and we will be able to go green. Look for those wheeling lights on the right side to go red. When those go off, we go green. Light sequence is started. Revs are up. Lights are on. And they're out. We're underway. Watch for this standing start. Not a lot of guys have done this yet, but looks like everybody gets off clean, Jeremy.
Not a good start, though, from the pole sitter, Chris Wilson. It's definitely Dean Martin from the outside in the Ford Mustang that has the edge going into turn one.
Kurt Resitano gets a good start, goes down to the inside right behind Andy Lee. It's side by side for Andrew Alcalante and Mark Wilkins in that Optima. Looks like everybody getting down through turn number one clean.
That was a great start by Dean Martin from the outside of the front row. Kind of the racing line coming out of the final corner, turn 20, that's where a little bit more rubber is laid down on that outside line, and Dean Martin taking full use of that, but it's still Christian Wilson there sliding that Aston Martin around in second place.
Yeah, he hasn't done a standing start here in Pirelli World Challenge competition yet, so that's a baptism by fire it was for Chris Wilson in that Aston Martin. Dean Martin able to get the jump on him in that Rahegan Racing Pitcher Cars East Ford Mustang.
Yeah, so the white Mustang leads the black, Ford Mustang that leads the black Aston Martin in second place. And then the black and yellow Ford Mustang in third, that is Andrew Aquilanti. And looking to the inside is Mark Wilkins in that Kia Optima, not able to make that move.
Yeah, you got to be careful there, because if you do that, you come down this long straightaway here in turn number 11. You want to make sure you get a good run, as we see Michael Cooper and Mark Clinton there in the back getting sideways and kind of touching there coming onto this back stretch.
Stretching the legs there now of the Mustang, and D Dean Martin got a really good exit onto that straightaway. He's pulled away three or four or five car lengths and down into the braking zone now for turn 12.
Yeah, there's a good battle here with Andy Lee and Kurt Resitano. Kurt in that Calvert Dynamics Ford Mustang. You got to be careful there. Four wheels off down on the inside. Pirelli World Challenge officials going to look at that. You are not allowed to go four wheels off and improve your position and get a run. So I'm sure the SCCA staff, Patrick DiNatale, will be looking at that. Our head chief steward here, and we've got a new addition to that program as well with Brian Till coming in as a driver steward.
As a driver steward, and he was very firm in his pre-race briefings to the drivers. If you put four wheels off the racetrack and the curbing and gain an advantage, you're going to get called for it. So it's up to Kurt Resitano. Now, Brian Till was perfectly clear. He said if you gain yourself an advantage, if you give that advantage up again, then you've got a chance of not being called for it. But Kurt Resitano now has had to realize what he did there and give up that position.
Yeah, he's going to need to get that back to Andy Lee, but he's got to be careful when he does that. He does not want Jack Baldwin to be able to pounce on him, or we got newcomer Ben Klusko right behind him. You know, Klukas in that Optima there behind him, sitting in the seventh position right now. Sorry, back to eighth. It's Jack Baldwin looking down to the inside of Andy Lee, trying to make that pass. Andy Lee defends to the inside. One move, you're allowed. Comes right off the corner, able to hold down that sixth place.
Close racing there for third, fourth, and fifth. There is Jack Baldwin with the Kia right behind him. Good battle up front, though. Through those first few corners, the Aston Martin able to close in here, and particularly through the S's. The Aston now almost back onto the rear bumper of the number 50 Ford Mustang. When they get on the straightaway, however, the Mustang seems to have a little bit of an edge.
Yeah, absolutely perfect. This is Detroit horsepower versus European handling. That Aston Martin Vantage GT4, a little better in the twisty parts. We come down here into the braking zone. The Mustang's got a little bit more weight, but has a lot more motor. Dean Martin's going to put his foot down like he does a lot. Grand Sanitation and Watson Racing helping out with Pitcher Cars East and Rahegan Racing and Dean Martin. So a lot of support coming from Dean Martin here this year. Won a lot of races last year, but also had a lot of failures last year and some incidents. Went through three cars last year looking for better this.
Yeah, what a great jump again onto the straightaway there by Dean Martin. Stretches the legs off that Ford Mustang, edges away from the Aston Martin, but now they'll come into the braking zone here and through this next complex of corners, and we'll see the Aston begin to close in again.
Yeah, Chris Wilson was in that car all day yesterday. Did not do the test day, however, as Max Riddle was running the test day and then ended up with that illness. And Chris Wilson still getting acclimated to the Pirelli World Challenge. A good shot of the number 36 Kia Motors America of Ben Klukas. But back to Mark Wilkins, who's running in the fourth place. Now, that car is the only front-wheel drive car in the GTS category, and that asking those Pirelli P0 tires to do a lot on the front of that 2-liter turbocharged Optima, the suspension travel, the movement, the braking, the steering, all going through those Pirelli P0s.
Yeah, they really are working hard on that Kia Optimus, two Kia Optimus, number 38 and a number 36, completed the first lap in fourth place for 38 of Mark Wilkins, and in eighth place for the 38 of Pirelli World Challenge rookie Ben Klukas.
Jack Baldwin right in the pre-grid was down there, and the crew had the front hood up, and they were replacing it. Looked like the fuel pump or trying to find something in the fuel system that was a problem when they went to go fire the car. Looks like they did fix that problem. No ill results so far, other than he's running in the seventh position. As Ben Klukas down to the inside of Jack Baldwin coming up to turn number one. We'll watch the exit to see if he was able to make that pass, and he does. Ben Klukas got around Jack Baldwin for seventh.
So that's the pass before position up at turn one. We're on to lap three now. Battles all the way through here. You can see Dean Martin is really under pressure now from that 07 car, the pole sitter, Chris Wilson.
Yeah, I think if this was any other racetrack other than Circuit of the Americas, Chris Wilson would have got around Dean Martin and pulled away. But I believe that the straightaways here, that he's able to pull enough distance so when Chris Wilson catches back up to him, Dean Martin's able to pull back away again when he gets to the next straightaway. We'll have to see how this plays out because Dean Martin looks like he's sliding a little bit down through those X's, heating those tires up. Look at Wilson looking down to the inside, trying to see if he can make a move. Dean Martin defends just a little bit, but wants to get a good run here onto the straightaway.
Speaking to Dean yesterday, he's really thrilled with the balance of that car. He says it's really good on a long run. It looks after its tires very well. He says he can do consistent lap times. He's hoping that's going to play into his favor. But right now, in terms of ultimate lap speed, it looks like the Aston Martin might be a little bit quicker, but it's that Ford Mustang with the advantage. That is the car that's out front. But look, in third place, Andrea Aquilanti is closing in on these two leaders.
Yeah, he sure is. Chris Wilson, fastest lap so far of the race, only three laps in here with a 218.1 3 is running about 2/10 of a second quicker than Dean Martin and 3/10 of a second faster than Andrew Aquilante. So they got their work cut out. Got to give a good shout out. We saw him earlier on the screen, though, to Kurt Resitano. He's going to move all the way up to 5th place, started in the 7th spot. So good run for him in that Phoenix Performance Ford Mustang.
Yeah, just a brief gap, maybe about 10 to 15 car lengths between the 3rd and the 4th place cars. The 4th place car being that Kia Optima. Now coming through that triple apex right-hander, great turn 16, 17 and 18, really challenging corners here at Circuit of the Americas, but under increasing pressure from Kurt Resitano. Look at that Mustang, it holds the inside front wheel way off the ground coming through turn 19.
Yeah, it's exciting stuff. It'd be neat to put like a cone down there and see if you can clear it to get those tires so high. And Mark Wilkins has his hands full now with Kurt Resitano as he's tucking in right behind the back bumper of that Kia Optima, down the front stretch, across the line, 3 laps into the books. Resitano down to the inside, trying to make the pass in the braking zone into turn number 1. I think Mark Wilkins sort of said, you know what, I think I'm going to give that up and try to go back under the over-under here, back through turn number 2.
Great battling here for the fourth position there. It's Resitano just about has the advantage, but I think it's Mark Wilkins, yes indeed, who gets the move back going to turn 4. Wow, that's a heck of a move from the Kia there of Mark Wilkins.
Yeah, absolutely. Just kept his foot down on the exit of turn number 2 and went right back around Kurt Resitano into the braking zone of turn number 3, that little tight little chicane. But Chris Wilson putting the pressure on Dean Martin down through turn number 6, out of here, turn number 7, over the hill, drop down into number 8 and number 9. You go down through 10 right here, drops off the crest. Hard braking zone for turn 11, get a good run onto the straightaway. Here's your battle for first in our GTS category. Of course, your online coverage here for the GTS is brought to you by Ford. We got a Ford Mustang leading. I don't think it could be better than that. Actually, two Ford Mustangs in the top 5. Wow, Kurt Resitano way up on 2 wheels. He clipped that inside curb there in turn number 11.
And Andy Lee is closing in on the back of that Mustang too. That Chevrolet Camaro, that Bondurant school car, the bright yellow car in 6th place at the moment. Closing up a little bit now on Kurt Resitano. On the straightaway, though, once again, it's the Mustangs that have the edge over the competitors, it seems, in a straight line. But through the twiddly bits, it's anybody's guess.
Yeah, top 7 has pulled away from the rest of the field. And that's back Ben Klukas in the second of those Kia Optimas in 7th. And Derek DeBoer, he's up in the 8th place. Jack Roush Jr. in 9th. And Jack Baldwin back to 10th. Not sure if there's problems with Jack Baldwin. He's just starting to fall back.
He did have a little bit of a problem in qualifying. I was talking to him after qualifying. He did have some fuel pressure difficulties with that car. And then you saw them on the grid, Jeff Lepper, and they were working on that car on the grid even to try and figure out what was the problem with the fuel pressure on that number 73 Porsche Cayman S.
Here goes Chris Wilson. He made a little glimpse to the inside there, trying to see if he can get it done down there into turn number 19. Down here into turn number 20, getting ready to come on to this front stretch and up that hill. 130 feet of elevation from the bottom of that straightaway to the top of turn number 1.
Great battle at the front of the field. 3 cars are part of that battle. It is Dean Martin who leads in 2nd place. It's Chris Wilson in the Aston Martin, a 2nd of the Ford Mustangs. Andrew Aquilante in 3rd place. And a bit of a gap back to the battle for 4th place between Mark Wilkins, who's just about holding off Kurt Resitano. And then another little bit of a gap as they came across the line to Andy Lee. But Andy Lee is charging hard and trying to reduce that deficit.
Yeah, you can really see Andrew Aquilante when he hits those curves and pulls the car back over. You see that flex, and he's got to be just praying that those guys start racing side by side. If we can just get... There goes Chris Wilson, getting a great run onto the outside, down into turn number 8. Goes to the inside of Dean Martin. New race leader, Chris Wilson.
What a great opportunistic maneuver there by Chris Wilson. He saw his opportunity, and he grasped it. He just had a great run around the outside of 7 and into 8 and able to make the pass. But now the Mustang gets on the beams again, coming out of the corner. And there's 3 cars. It's 2 abreast for 2nd place. It's just Chris Wilson who leads into turn 11.
Yeah, Dean Martin now on Andrew Aquilante side by side. The 2 Mustangs going to drag race down this straightaway. Dean Martin had to pinch it a little tight through there. You saw him hit the brake lights on the entrance down into turn number 10. Sideways through there, was afraid that he didn't want to run into the sideways of Chris Wilson. Did a good job saving both of those cars, but that's going to affect him. He might be back to 3rd.
Well, that's brilliant news for Chris Wilson. That's exactly what he needed, because he knew he was going to be pretty much dead meat on the straightaway. The Ford Mustangs are much quicker on the straight than the Aston Martin. But because those 2 Mustangs were battling side by side into the corner at the beginning of the straightaway, neither of them can get a good run out of the corner. So now Chris Wilson has to put his head down. He's got to pull out enough of an advantage here through these corners here, and again, particularly through the S's on the next lap, so he doesn't come under pressure again next time around for from the Mustangs. That was a great move by Chris Wilson.
Looks like Andrew Aquilante is a little bit better through the S's than Dean Martin, too, and that Mustang got a little better setup maybe, or just prefers Dean Martin's wild, aggressive driving style. Getting word from pit lane that Jack Baldwin, unfortunately, having transmission problems, using one of those IMCO gearboxes again, and unfortunately, not able to get going. Issue there.
It's not been Jack Roush Jr.'s day. He had a short speed just Baldwin. Before the start. Jack Baldwin, I beg your pardon. Jack Roush Jr. also had a problem in the qualifying session as well. They found afterwards a broken boil joint in the front suspension. They changed that for the race because he qualified a lot farther back than we would otherwise have expected. But certainly awful news for Jack Baldwin there. A great run through the practice sessions yesterday, but problems early in the race.
Yeah, he's back into 11th place, just trying to salvage what he can and try to get some points here in the first round. The last thing you need to try to do is get a DNF or not finish, and then now that crew's got a lot of work to do because we got another race tomorrow.
Well, that's right. You need to complete 50% of the race distance in order to score points in the Pirelli World Challenge. That was a rule that was brought in last year, and with over 150 points up for grabs for the winner of the race, with the various bonus points that are on offer, you want to make sure you score at least some points to keep yourself in the championship record.
Yeah, he's got about 8 more minutes to do that, so he's still steady in 11th. His last lap time was a 2:22. He's about 2 seconds slower than the guys behind him, so if he could salvage something and just stay out for another about 7.5 more minutes, Jack Baldwin will be able to score at least some points and try to get 50% of that race distance.
So back to 11th place now. His last lap time was a 2:22. So he's only losing 3 or 4 seconds. He's doing the best he can, is Jack Baldwin. He's a veteran. You know, he knows how to coax a sick car home. That's what he's got to do this afternoon.
Yeah, Dean Martin starting to lose touch with Chris Wilson. Still under battle and attack from Andrew Aquilante. Mark Wilkins holding down that fourth position over Kurt Rezzatano. Kurt still putting the pressure on, just not able to make a pass in that Kia Optima. But Kurt Rezzatano is not able to make a pass in the Ford Mustang over that Kia Optima of Mark Wilkins. But Chris Wilson pulled the last time by was a 1.1 second gap, and it looks like he's extending that now, Jeremy.
He is, particularly as they're going through the S's here. Now that Aston Martin V8 Vantage is super fast through the twisty sections, that sort of infield section there after the end of the back straightaway, then through that triple right-hander, and then down through the S's as well. The car is really, really fast.
Yeah, very fast. We knew that was sort of a characteristic of this track and that car. It'll be better in the handling portions of the course. It'll suffer down the straightaways, but he's able to maximize the efforts through the S's and maintain that gap down the straightaway against these two Ford Mustangs coming down from Dean Martin and Andrew Aquilante. Andrew running out of the Phoenix Performance, like I said before at the start of the show, 6 cars maintained this weekend by Phoenix Performance, with Preston Calvert, Kurt Rezzatano, and Andrew Aquilante driving in this race. And then Preston Calvert also driving the brand new GT Cup presented by Momo in his Porsche. And then they also have a couple touring cars they're running now in the touring car class now, with Andrew Aquilante driving in TC.
Yeah, it's very cool, isn't it?
And a V6 Mustang, so it's a full house over there at Phoenix Performance.
Yeah, it's good to see that V6 Mustang in the TC class again. That's kind of an experimental. I was talking to Andrew this morning, telling me it's a kind of an experimental suck it and see thing to see with that new V6 Mustang in the TC and see how it kind of plans out. It's a one race program at the moment, but they certainly hope to have that car out on a regular basis.
See a good battle back there going for fourth. Mark Wilkins and Kurt Rezzatano, we were just talking about that, and now Andy Lee has joined that fray there. I got to think maybe just a little bit that Mark Wilkins, not holding them up, but definitely battling with Mark Wilkins, trying to get up there. As we see, there is Wilkins, Rezzatano, Andy Lee, and now Ben Klukas, all 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th on your screen.
Once again, the fleet of footedness through the S's of the Aston Martin, able to pull out enough advantage so he doesn't come under threat again down that big long back straightaway. But that battle for fourth and fifth is really heating up.
Oh, big slide from Andrew Aquilante there. Wow, that's hurt turn 13 through turn 15 complex.
Yeah, I was watching that car yesterday. It seems to be set up so soft, it really rolls an awful lot. He said the handling felt good, but he's only on three wheels most of the way around, so I guess a bit less rolling resistance, and maybe look after some of the tires a little bit. But boy, it looked like a bit of a handful to me.
There was a good shot of Dan Martinson in that gear tie Ford Mustang Boss 302. Got a little kiosk set up here, giving away samples of his product. It's a pretty good product. If you don't have them, you can get them at your local Sears store. I've seen them there. The gear ties are great to wrap around some bags and tie them all up. They're a completely reusable tie. Great product from Dan Martinson. There's a good shot of Tony Gaples in that Black Dog Speed Shop Chevy Camaro and Jack Roush Jr. and his Mustang. Back on our leader here with Chris Wilson in that royal purple, the Racers Group Aston Martin Vantage GT4. You see Dean Martin and Andrew Alcalante sort of settling into that second and third place. I think that maybe they battled for each other for a minute. Now maybe it's, let's let these Mustangs team up and try to run down that Aston Martin.
Yeah, you might be right. Certainly, but Dean Martin, that car sliding there as he comes through the S's right behind him. Andrew Aquilanti's car doing exactly the same thing. Dean was saying yesterday, his car looked a bit tail happy, but he was really pleased with the balance of it. And he said it was good and consistent. And he hoped to be as strong at the end of the race as he is at the beginning.
Well, we'll find out near that end of the race. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Today's coverage of the Pirelli World Challenge Championships is being brought to you by Nissan, innovation that excites, by Motul, official lubricants of the Pirelli World Challenge, and by the Kia Optima, not your average midsize sedan.
Now's the time, no delay, gotta get going now, there's no more time to waste, more speed, little less haste, 100 miles of running, never touch the brakes, see they're counting, counting, we can't let them wait, never late, cause it's time, gonna move quick, gotta move faster, wanna speed up, gonna move faster, time is time, it has no mass muscles.
Its effects on society really came about because not because I was selfish and wanted one for myself, which I did. It's because I had a passion my whole life. I wanted to teach myself to build computers. I wanted to build these things for free. I just wanted to do it for the world. And, you know, when you want something, that's what you do the best.
And we're back live. Welcome to our viewers at worldchallengetv.com. And once again, if you're at this great facility here at Circuit of the Americas and you got an iPhone or an Android phone and you're with an earshot of the microphone, go ahead and tune your iPad, your iPhone, your Android phone, your tablet, your computer. If it has a monitor and a computer internet connection, go to world-challengetv.com. Watch all the action live. We appreciate all of our worldwide viewers listening and watching right now. It's Chris Wilson leading over Dean Martin and Andrew Alcalante, first, second, and third. It's Kurt Resitano who got around Mark Wilkins during that break now for fourth. And then fifth is Mark. Sixth, Andy Lee, who's lost touch and under battle and attack from Ben Klukas in the second of those two Kia Optimas. If you look on the roof right there of Kurt Resitano's car, you'll see one of those brand new Prime X Replay XD cameras, a new partner coming in. Replay XD, the official camera provider of the Pirelli World Challenge. Now you'll see some good onboard shots and those great roof shots from Replay XD. You have a chance to win that camera each and every race. We're going to give away a free Primex Replay XD action camera. All you have to do is text your number to 313131. Text the word COTA, where we're at, Circuit of the Americas, COTA, to 313131 for your chance to win. Once again, text COTA to 313131 for your chance to win one of those Replay cameras. Does that count for us too?
I hope so.
Maybe I can get one. I don't know.
We seem to have lost Andy Lee, don't we? Nope. He's missing from this picture at the moment as the fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh place cars come down into turn 12.
That's actually Jeff Reeves right there coming back. Oh, and Mark Clinton, a little spin there coming on this. Oh, right in front of Jack Baldwin. Jack Baldwin has to go sideways down through the dirt. That's in the exit of turn number 11 onto the straightaway. And boy, Jack Baldwin, big heads up from that driver there. But Jack's still in it with that transmission problem. 15th he's dropped back to, but we're at 20 minutes and 35 seconds. He's done half the lap, so he will get points. And I think that's what that looking for, and then try to salvage whatever finish he can get.
Yeah, you know, at the moment he's running in 15th place. There's only a few cars behind him, so he doesn't want to, he wants to make sure he doesn't do any terminal damage that's going to keep him out of tomorrow's race. But the good news is they certainly have plenty of time to repair whatever is wrong in that reset MD Porsche Cayman S.
Now, because it could cause a lot more problems than just transmission and gearbox, right? You spin a motor up or...
Yeah, all sorts of nasty things can happen.
There was that Dan Martinson again in that gear tie Ford Mustang from Capaldi Racing. Trying to get a good shot here behind Jack Baldwin. We should see, and Andy Lees dropped all the way back to 10th place now. Unfortunate for that driver. Not sure what happened. We'll try to get a word from pit lane to see what happened to the number 20 Best IT Bondurant Camaro. There is, once again, Jack Baldwin, that reset MD. Also has a lot of support there from Stop Tech Brakes and Motul, and doing work with the Goldcrest Motorsports, and that's that GT Sport Racing team. We don't know what the problems were earlier with the fuel problem, but definitely a transmission issue. We got word down on pit lane.
I would assume that Andy Lee must have had a spin, because all of a sudden he was, and I guess it must have been up at turn one, because I think he was pretty close on the previous lap. But now we've got a renewed battle for second place. It's Dean Martin who turned a couple of pretty quick laps there to reduce the deficit to the race leader Chris Wilson, but now he's under pressure again from Andrew Aquilanti in third place on the way down the hill towards turn 12.
Yeah, coming down there, down that straightaway. He's been pressuring him every so often on these corners, and I think Andrew's just kind of finding his space. He's going to have his teammate, if these guys start going side by side, Kurt Rezzatano will come up there, maybe support the team boss there, but... He's kind of far back, currently sitting about 4.5 seconds behind this group for the podium, second and third.
Yeah, those two Mustangs, though, they seem to be handling very, very differently, but they're certainly turning very similar lap times and running there in tandem in second and third place. The white car, the Picture Cars East entry of Rahegan Racing for Dean Martin in second place, and right behind him, that distinctive black and yellow, the wasp-colored car of Andrew Aquilani, pressuring Dean Martin as much as he can.
Yeah, Dean Martin got a new set of Forgeline wheels on that Ford Mustang as well, and Forgeline, a contingency sponsor here in the Pirelli World Challenge, joining up for the 2015 season. So awesome job from Forgeline wheels. We really appreciate that, and going to get a set of Forgelines on my car, I hope. So depending on that whole budget thing again on whatever car I get. So I don't think they'll make that nice of wheels for the car I can afford. But Chris Wilson in that racers group, Aston Martin Racing, he got Orion on that car, Royal Purple all helping out. Dean Martin doing everything he can to hold off Andrew Aquilanti. Andrew's saying, you know what, I drive a Mustang. I have no clue you can make a Mustang this wide. You got to take a little clinic here from Dean Martin on how wide you can make one of those Ford Mustangs.
Yeah, and certainly the Dean Martin car looks a lot more tail happy than Andrew Aquilanti. They're both sliding around here, particularly through the S's. That's where Dean Martin struggles the most, through that right, left, right, left, right, left sequence of corners. Tremendously, it's a signature, one of the several signature parts of this racetrack here at Circuit of the Americas, and a tightening sequence of corners. But Dean Martin there, he's losing a lot of time to the Aston Martin, but Andrew Aquilanti in third place, not quite able to make a move, but he's going to look now to the inside at turn 11.
Yeah, down into the braking zone. Can he make that pass? Andrew Aquilanti to the inside of Dean Martin. We'll watch the exit here coming down the straightaway to see if he does, and Andrew Aquilanti up to second place over Dean Martin. Now, I think Dean Martin was holding up Andrew a little bit. We'll see if Andrew can pull up, and there is the answer right there. Smoke out of the tailpipe of Andy Lee's Camaro. That was done, so we found out he probably dropped the valve or had some engine problems, and unfortunate for that young man, the bad luck continues for Andy Lee.
God, yeah, if he has... without for the bad luck, he had no luck at all, does he? What a shame for Andy Lee. It's amazing. He's in his 30s now. He still seems to be a very young man, but he drives beautifully, and he seems to have had all sorts of problems last year. He's got 5 wins under his belt in the Pirelli World Challenge. Win number 6 is not going to come today.
Yeah, he's a driving instructor there at the Bondurant School in Phoenix, Arizona. Multi-talent, and they built that car really in the garages there at the Bondurant School. He's got a brand new Camaro Z28 being built by 3R Racing in Colorado, from K-Pax Racing fame. So 3R's been involved in the Pirelli World Challenge, supporting a couple cars here, also doing the Ryder Engineering Camaro. So good things coming from 3R. Hopefully we'll see Andy Lee in that brand new car at St. Petersburg.
Yeah, that would be good to see Andy in a new car, certainly. There is our race leader.
So that time by, Andrew was about 4/10 of a second slower than Chris Wilson. So Chris Wilson, even though Andrew got around him, hasn't been able to pull, or is slowly pulling away.
Two reasons for that. Number one, Dean Martin was particularly slow, I think, through the S's on lap. And number two, Andrew Acquilanti had to compromise his optimal line going in to turn 11 to make that pass. He's using every bit of the racetrack through the S, isn't he?
Yeah,
Andrew Acquilanti.
We saw Andrew Acquilanti in the touring car race. If you're joining us live at worldchallengetv.com, actually broke one of those tie rods on his Mustang on the left front, cutting those curbs. So got to be very, very careful here, especially in that GTS Mustang. He's already had it happen to him once. Doesn't want to happen again.
I wonder why that car set up so soft, because it lifts the inside wheel way over that curb. It's not even hitting it.
Got both of the Kia Optimas from Kia Motors America and Kinetic Motorsports. Mark Wilkins leading his teammate newcomer Ben Klukas. And Ben, you know, one of those guys that a lot of racing, we haven't heard his name much in America, but a lot of international racing he's done.
He has indeed. He's done a few races over here, but not very many. And this is his first full season program in the United States. I'm very much looking forward to it. But right behind him is Derek DeBoer. He's doing a fine job there in number 09. Aston Martin V8 Vantage. He really is doing a fine job of hanging on there. He's not a professional driver by any means, but he does have a lot of experience in all sorts of different sorts of cars. And over the last 12 months or so, he's been driving more and more frequently and getting closer and closer to the front running pace.
Yeah, doing a great job. BRM Chronograph on the side of that car, a big supporter of them, and they help him. And of course, BRM, our sponsor of our GTA category, going for that BRM Chronograph at the end of the year. I need to see if I can find a way to get into a GTA car, because I would love
to
have
one of those,
BRM
Jeff
chronographs. Yeah, I just, champagne dream, whatever it was. Yeah.
There you go, I love it. So here's this 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th now, all separated by probably 10, 12 car lengths, around about a second or so on the road between each one. But Kurt Rezzitano there, what a fine job he is doing in the 4th place there, in car number 37. This is his first start in the Pirelli World Challenge. He's done some racing on and off, but as Jeff Leppard was saying a little while ago, he started off effectively as a shop boy at Phoenix American Racing Team, based there in Pennsylvania.
There's Jeff Reeves,
the teammate to Andy Lee.
No, it looks like that's Andy Lee back out there. I apologize. That's Andy Lee. Sorry about that. That's number 20 at the top of turn one. Looks like they probably thought it might have been a fitting or a hose run. They got that fixed, but it looks like it's a lot more terminal than that, as he's pulled off driver's left on the exit of turn number one.
Very consistent lap times for our race leader, Chris Wilson. Again, vastly experienced in all sorts of different cars, turning laps of high 2 minute 18s, just below 2 minute 19. And last time around, the gap back to Andrew Acquilanti just came down by a couple of tenths of a second or so not enough to seriously worry Chris Wilson, who's managing his pace at the front of the field in that 07 Aston Martin.
Yeah, good run here from Jack Roush Jr. in that Roush Performance Ford Mustang, doing a great job. We're looking forward to talk to all these Mustang drivers. They say we just can't wait to get our hands on that 2015 Mustang. That's they'll hopefully debut that near the end of the season, get a race or two before we go full season in 2016 with that brand new 2016 Mustang. But these drivers are sort of chopping at the bit with that new car. But Mustang can't be going too bad when you're running second and third here in the GTS category.
No, we've got a new 10th place car now. Dan Martinson, Lou Gelotti appeared to have a problem last time around. He's fallen back now to 13th place. He was running in the top 10 on his return to the Pirelli World Challenge, but now has dropped several positions back to 13th for car number 28, Lou Gelotti.
Yeah, it's a 33-second different lap time that last time by, so must have had a spin or an off there, and hopefully he can recover and get back, try to get back into the top 10.
Here come the leaders now through turn, out of turn 18, into the final couple of right-handers to complete what will be lap 13 here in this 50-minute race. We're over halfway through, just about a half an hour gone, so 20 minutes remaining in this motor race, coming around the final corner, and Andrew Acquilanti was a little bit closer, perhaps, this time around.
Yeah, Chris Wilson, though, that Aston Martin Vantage, you just look at him, once he pulled away, was able to pull a gap a little over 2.2 seconds, but Andrew Acquilanti is coming. I thought that Dean Martin might have been holding him up a little bit. I called a little bit earlier, and he's slowly chipping away, slowly chipping away. That lap, he was 7/10 of a second quicker. The gap was 1.9. It's down to 1.5.
That's right. For the first time, I think, in the race, the race leader, Chris Wilson, was down above 2 minutes 19.1. And again, a very, very good lap there for Andrew Aquilanti. Andrew Aquilanti's best lap in the race is a 1:18.2. Last time around was at, 2 minutes 18.2. Last time was 2:18.4. So good consistent times there from Andrew Aquilanti. And Dean Martin, he's hanging in there now in third place again.
He's still trying a little twitch there from Derek DeBoer coming down through the S's and that Lex Tempest Aston Martin supporting that car. And there's his teammate that's leading overall, Chris Wilson, stepping in for Max Riddle. And it's got a, you know, I can't think of anything worse than being sick, having to give your car up, not being able to race, and then watching the guy that took your seat over running away with this thing.
I can think of a lot of things worse than that. I can see the car being backed into something else rather heavily. No, I'm sure Max will be thrilled. I mean, Max is, he and Chris Wilson have become very much a team over these last few years. Max has employed Chris Wilson effectively as his driver coach. Is that Jack Baldwin?
There is Jack Baldwin. The transmission in that Porsche Cayman finally gave up the ghost. We're 30 minutes into a 50-minute race, so well over halfway. Sacrifice as many points as he can get. It looks like he's going to go back to, I think, Preston Calvert's still out there, and Andy Lee is done. So right now, his best finish he can get, I believe, is 17th for Jack Baldwin.
Yeah, 17th is a few, three or four championship points better than 18th. So as many as you can get, Jack, he'll be relatively content with that. He knows he doesn't have an opportunity to score front-running points this weekend, but anything he can get is going to be good news.
There's Jeff Reeves in that Shadowworks Best IT Chevy Camaro, the Z28 version now, getting out of the way of the leaders. Good heads-up driving by Jeff Reeves. Still on his development of not only the car, but racing in Pirelli World Challenge Series. So got a good teammate there with Andy Lee, kind of guiding him and coaching him along. And Jeff Reeves had some problems, you said, mechanically earlier. Saw him do one of those hardship laps to make sure everything was going. Let's see the gap this time. It drops down to 1.2 seconds, so picked up another 0.3 that lap with Andrew Aquilanti.
Indeed he did, and 1 minute 19.4 for our race leader, Chris Wilson. The fastest lap he has turned in that car was a 1:18.1, so a full second away from that. The two Mustangs behind him, meanwhile, they are lapping within a few tenths of a second of their best laps in this race. And now you can see Andrew Aquilanti sliding that car through the S's, but still the Aston, through that section of the track, still has a slight advantage. Advantage for the vantage, right?
Oh, there you go. Got those words in, right? Oh, Andrew Aquilanti, a big swirl there. He's going to drop four wheels almost on the exit there of turn number 9, down into 10. Hard braking zone into turn number 11. He is pushing as hard as he can in that Phoenix Performance Mustang, but he is coming. We're going to heat up the battle for the overall lead here in GTS. I give it a couple more laps. Andrew Aquilanti is going to be right on the back bumper of that Aston Martin.
Five-time SCCA national champion is Andrew Aquilanti. Huge of a man experience in all sorts of different sedans, and he's making full use of this car here. He's only had five starts in the Pirelli World Challenge before now. His best finish so far is a couple of third place finishes way back in 09, but he's already now in second place. But he's got his eyes firmly set on that race victory and the car of Chris Wilson directly now in front of him.
Yeah, that gap was 1.2 seconds last time by a little less than a second now. Yep. So still picking up time after time after time. Need to radio Chris Wilson and tell him to turn that wick up a little bit. That might be as fast as he can go. Dean Martin's car looks like it's fallen off a little bit. The handling has gone away on that pitcher car, East Verhegen Racing Ford Mustang. Not able to keep up, as you see. There is Jeff Reeves letting Derek DeBoer get by. So good, once again, heads-up driving from that driver.
Just ahead of those two, the two Kias are pretty much together on the road now. Ben Klukas has caught up to Mark Wilkins. Those two running in the fifth and sixth places.
Saw Derek DeBoer go by. Did not see Michael Cooper. There's Tony Gables in the number 11 Black Dog Speed Shop Chevy Camaro Z28. Jack Roush Jr. right behind him in that number 60 Roush Performance Ford Mustang 302.
Yeah, that was Michael Cooper. It was Michael Cooper ahead of Jack Roush Jr., I think. So Michael Cooper there in the eighth position. And looking for a good solid run. Get some points on the board. Be hoping for some help from the balance of performance, perhaps, as the season progresses with that brand new Chevrolet Camaro Z20. It's actually not a brand new chassis on that car, same as the two best IT cars. They've been updated from their last year's specification, but running with new engines and different wheels and tires and brakes and all sorts of different aerodynamic tweaks on that car as well in that Z28 body kit.
It's a good shot of Michael Cooper, that number 11 Black Dog Speed Shop Z28, right behind Dan Martinson. On my timing chart, it shows Martinson is behind Cooper, so we'll have to see if that updates here as they cross the line. A good shot of that gear tie Mustang. Capaldi Racing doing a good job teaming up with Roush here again this season, and all prepping and maintaining. Got a good chance to talk to Jack Roush Jr. A little bit earlier on Wednesday, right before the park day, and they were talking how they, he's known Leo his whole life, and it's so great to be there and kind of share that data amongst all four cars versus, just having his own deal. Here is Kurt Resitano is up to fourth around the Kias. You see a good shot of him there, and Mark Wilkins is under attack now from his teammate. I believe Klukas has gotten around Mark Wilkins, so Ben Klukas, somewhere that last lap before, Wilkins was ahead of Klukas, and now Ben Klukas showing the old veteran of the Kia Optima team, hey, the new guy can come in here, and the master versus the teacher, I guess?
Yeah.
Student.
Mark Wilkins was very much in the championship running last year in GTS category, but unfortunately some mechanical problems took care of that effectively, but he's had a few glitches this weekend as well with that car, but generally speaking the car's running well, but it's still they don't have the reliability they really are looking for in that Kia Optima Turbo.
Yeah, new livery on the side of those cars as well, it looks really good. Kia has five cars here through that Kinetic Motorsports team, with three of our Kia Forte Coupes running in the TCA category. You saw race one earlier, you'll see race two later today in the touring car category. So huge conglomerate coming for Kia as the Manufacturers Championship last year, the 2014 Manufacturers Championship was Kia.
Yep.
And they got that by Nick Johnson in this car, getting that one bonus point for pole at Miller Motorsports Park, and that clinched them the championship.
Yeah, that was the consolation. They missed out on the drivers, but they won the manufacturers, and in many ways, for as far as Kia is concerned, that's, well, every bit as important, if not more so. Meanwhile, at the front of the field, Chris Wilson has very much got the message. The last two laps were a 2 minutes 18.7 and then a 2 minutes 18.4, and he's managed to stretch that gap over the second place car of Andrew Aquilanti, almost out now again to 2 seconds, which it was a little while ago. So again, Chris Wilson, the experience there showing he was managing his pace and now just stepping up a little, making sure Andrew Aquilanti doesn't get too close in second place.
And Ben Klukas has pulled away from Mark Wilkins, trying to run down Kurt Resitano. If any of those guys have a problem in the front and he can get around Resitano, he might slip into a podium spot here after starting all the way back in the ninth place. So good for him.
Yeah, very good run. Very good debut in a Pirelli World Challenge by Ben Klukas, who's in our race leader. Comes through turn 16. Is that 16, 17, 18? Where is he?
Yep. Oh, no,
he's coming through the
13, 15 complex.
Yeah, kind of infield complex there at the end of the back straightaway. It's a great place to watch there from that big grandstand at the end of the back straightaway. You can see the cars all the way through that section and around now onto 16, 17, and 18. That triple apex right-hander, great turn. Really a lot of fun through there. Downhill a little bit also into turn 19. And Chris Wilson, he's stretched that lead again now, almost to 2 seconds over the second place car of Andrew Aquilanti.
We'll see what the gap is next time by as it comes down into turn number 20 onto the front stretch. Your overall leader, once again, Chris Wilson. Michael Cooper and Dan Martinson starting to heat things up as they come down. Oh, sorry, that was Tony Gables, I apologize, trying to run down the number 11 Black Dog Speed Shop Chevy Camaro. Oh, and Dan Martin has something happen with that car. Smoke out the back. He's pulling over to the left. It does not sound like it has all the cylinders there. But number 11, Tony Gables. Oh, big replay there from some smoke. I believe that was, maybe a little lock up there on the left side coming down into turn number 11. Looks like he's still up to speed.
Yeah, that's kind of weird. There is our race leader one more time. Chris Wilson negotiating the this is now on to lap 18, when again last time around, once again a woman at 18.4. super consistent by Chris Wilson. He knows exactly what he's doing. He's pacing himself and he's stretching that lead over Aquilanti in second place, now up to almost 2.5 seconds last time around. And Dean Martin, having hung with Andrew Aquilanti for quite a while, he's slipping back there in third place. still got a 10-second margin almost over the second of the Phoenix American cars of Kurt Rezzitano, and he's got about a couple of seconds over Ben Klukas. But Ben Klukas certainly in that fifth place Kia Optima car, number 36, that red and white car, has got his eyes set on the black and yellow Ford Mustang of Kurt Rezzitano.
You just saw the lights flash from Chris Wilson for Buzz McCall in that reset MD. Porsche Cayman does not want to get held up whatsoever. I'm sure Buzz will do a good job. He does. He pulls way off to the side, gives the inside to him, so Chris Wilson needs to pounce on it, go down to the inside. Pinched up just a little bit there. That's a really tight complex of corners through turn number 13 and through 15 down here into turn 16. It is two little jaunts, but they call that one turn into this whole 16, 17, 18 complex.
Yeah, it's Chris Wilson there just playing the percentage game there. He doesn't race regularly in this series, so he doesn't know who all the drivers are, who he can kind of trust and who he can't. So taking extra caution, he knows he's got a slight pace advantage here over that Ford Mustang in second place. So the last thing he wants to do is take any risky moves. He's playing it as safe as he possibly can, and a very, very smart driving from Chris Wilson.
A little over 8 minutes remaining in this race, with Andrew Alcalante trying to get a little tiny bit of a draft around Buzz McCall down this straightaway. They crossed the line. The gap was 2.7 last time by. Sorry, this time by, just crossed the line. It was 2.2, I believe, last time by. So he's really pulling over a gap on Andrew Alcalante. Dean Martin falling back to the clutches of Kurt Rezzitano still. Kurt was about 0.2 seconds quicker the prior lap. Ben Klukas lapping a half a second quicker than the top cars right now, so he is on a flyer. He is coming. Is there enough time that Ben Klukas might be able to get around Kurt Rezzitano? I don't think he's going to have anything for Dean Martin, however.
I don't think so, but certainly Klukas is closing in quite quickly on Kurt Rezzitano. Last time around, he was about a half a second faster, and the gap between those cars is just over a second and a half, so do your math. That's about three laps to go. We've got how many minutes to go? 7.5 minutes to go in the race. So that's about three or four more laps to go. Can Ben Klukas catch Kurt Rezzitano?
We saw that Dan Martinson, that lockup that he had with the smoke out there. I apologize for the blown motorcycle. We were just watching a replay of him getting sideways, and then Tony Gables behind him getting completely sideways as well. So exciting stuff from our GTS category.
And the track's getting a bit slippery out there. There's a few cars moving around now in the later stages of this race into the final 7 minutes of the 50-minute motor race. And it's still Chris Wilson who leads by 15-20 car lengths over Andrew Alcalante in second place, and a kind of a similar margin back now to that White Pictures Cars East Ford Mustang of Dean Martin, the pole sitter.
You see Chris Wilson sort of diamond that corner off down through there. Andrew Alcalante trying all he can do to touch up on this, but yeah, you got to think when that gap started closing down a little bit, Chris Wilson just turned the wick up a little bit. Now he's backing it off a little bit. Just a great race management and great run
for
Chris Wilson.
Absolutely right. I mean, like I say, a huge amount of experience. Been one of the top instructors at Skip Barber Racing School for many, many years as Chris, and he passes on a lot of good information to a lot of young drivers. And Max Riddle, the guy who he generally shares that car with, has gained enormously from that experience of Chris Wilson. And Chris now has an opportunity to show that for himself. And good to see. He's a really good guy who's worked very, very hard to keep his racing career afloat. Doesn't come from an awful lot of money, so he's worked hard to make sure the opportunities are opening up for himself, and like I say, taking full advantage of them right here at Circuit of the Americas.
Well, a win in the Pirelli World Challenge GTS class is a good resume booster when you add that on to that. Ben Klukas still lapping about 0.7 seconds quicker now than Kurt Rezzitano that time by. So continuing to get time. The gap, though, however, is over 5.7 seconds. So not what they're looking for, but I apologize. 2.3 seconds is the gap for Mark Wilkins to Ben Klukas. Chris Wilson getting held up a little bit there in the S's by the Travel Clean car with Nick Asan, the number 34.
Yeah, Nick's struggling, isn't he, this weekend?
Yeah, he sure is. This is his third car make in three different years. He went from the Acura TSXs in the GTS category to the Aston Martin Vantage GT4 last year, and now he's in a Ford Mustang this year, so three different platforms. And you know, that can get to a driver. It takes you a little bit to get used to a car. Not a lot of off-season testing as they were getting the cars built there through Capaldi Racing, so we'll see, Nick. He'll be okay. But yep. Not having the race he wanted here today.
Nope, not yet. Just getting to grips with that car still. Here come our leaders now down into turn 12. We're on lap 20 with probably, I would say, two more laps to go, possibly three, probably two. And it's a good, comfortable lead now that Chris Wilson has over that second place car of Andrew Aquilanti, who himself now is having to fight past that slower traffic.
Well, if you're Chris Wilson, you're going, how much longer, how much longer, yes, how much longer? He's hoping it's only two more laps versus three more laps. Dean Martin and Andrew Aquilanti behind him are going, gosh, I hope we have like 15 or 20 more laps. Let's keep this thing going, see if we can catch up.
Yeah, 4 minutes to go, less than 4 minutes to go is across the line here, so they'll do one more lap and then they'll get the white flag, I believe. So I think just about two laps to go.
Getting word from pit lane that car 35, Preston Calvert, a Phoenix Performance Mustang, is on pit lane, or sorry, out of the race due to lack of fuel problem. We still have time left in this race if those other Mustangs can't run on a fuel full load for 50 minutes here. Now, mind you, at this track, you're on the gas flat out for approximately 80% of the course. So it's going to use a lot of fuel, and if you just misdid your calculations a little bit, they may not have put enough in there to help save some weight. But the teammate, too, your second-place car, Andrew Aquilanti, car's out of fuel. This might become a story here for these Mustangs near the end.
Yeah, that's not good, certainly. And, you know, it's been an all-green race. There's been no caution period. Look at that Mustang waving the inside wheel. He turns from right to left to right again. The inside unloaded front wheel way up in the air. Tremendous sight. Great shot. If you've got a good camera out here, there's some good shots to be had of these cars here. Colorful cars and plenty of horsepower, but great pictures as well.
Chris Wilson, don't know what much more to say about this. This has been not domination of the race. He did have to get back around Dean Martin for that lead, but once he did, he pulled away from here. Ooh. And
Dean Martin, excuse me for interrupting there, Jeff. Dean Martin got into turn 11 a little bit hot, didn't he?
He is pushing as hard as he can. Might be even getting a little bit of a long pedal there down into that hard braking zone at turn number 11. But getting into that, you sort of come into that conservation mode there, Jeremy. You start getting near the end. They tell you, homie, we only got a couple minutes left. Does it save something?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, Chris, he's used to driving long distance races, so he knows all about fuel management, tire management, self-management. You know, you've got to look after yourself. These cars are pretty physical to drive, so you've got to make sure you're on top of everything, every single aspect of it to come away with a victory. Any win in the Pirelli World Challenge is going to be very, very hard earned, and that's exactly what Chris Wilson is doing this afternoon.
1.3 seconds is the gap from Kurt Resitano to Ben Lucas in that Kia Motors Optima. Still a top five run in your debut in a brand new car for Ben Lucas. Not a bad run in that Kia Motors America Kia Optima.
Very impressive, I would say, by Ben Lucas, 31-year-old from Northampton in the UK. There is the white flag for our race leader, Chris Wilson.
Yeah, one lap to go, a minute 20 left on the clock. So by the time they get back around, we're going to go a little bit. So about a 51-minute race, but not a big deal. But Chris Wilson getting that white flag. Now's the time. He's got a three-second lead, almost dead, 3 seconds exactly. And he's got to listen to every single screech and nut, bolt. Dean Martin driving four wheels off the exit, turn number one, pushing as hard as he can. Maybe there's something left in the tank for Dean Martin to try to make a run for second.
Yeah, closed it a little bit last time around. His last lap, actually, for Dean Martin, about three quarters of a second quicker than Andrew Aquilanti. Look how far that inside wheel is off the ground on that car number 32. It's absolutely amazing as he goes through the left-hander at turn four. Incredible. But Dean Martin is pushing on as hard as he can, but he doesn't seem to be getting any closer as they're coming through the S's for the last time.
Some tremendous rear grip coming out of that Mustang, able to pull that front nose up like that. And, oh, here is Jeff Rees. I thought I saw some smoke, wasn't sure who that was coming from. The car sounds like it's at full song, but definite smoke coming out of that. Doesn't look like he's leaving any liquid, but he's right in front of the leaders.
Yeah, where there's smoke, there's generally oil too, isn't there? Where there's smoke, there's fire. There's normally, but hopefully no fire. But it doesn't look good for the second of those two bright yellow Camaros.
So Chris Wilson coming down into the braking zone at turn number 12. You see that smoke from Jeff Reeves, Shadow Works Best IT Camaro. not how the best IT team wanted to start their 2015 season or their round one here.
Chris Wilson has really backed off on this last lap. Is that all of a sudden his lead is not very much over Andrew Aquilani in second place. Just eight or ten car lengths now as they come into the final sequence of corners.
Yeah, I think he sees that smoke up there and he's just taking it easy, being careful. I've seen him alter his line a couple of times, trying to stay offline in case there's any fluids down on the track. What a great heads-up driving, and really is been the pace of this field in the GTS class today.
Certainly has, but it's been a fine run, and there is that smoky Camaro coming through the last couple of corners. He's going to get to the finish of the race, and there is now just one corner to go for Chris Wilson in car number 07.
Yeah, coming down into the braking zone at turn number 20, hits that apex perfectly, come off the exit, get in the gas. Jeff Reeves getting out of the way there, way off to the inside, down into the braking zone. And Dean Martin trying everything he can to get around Andrew Aquilani, but it's going to be Chris Wilson, your round one winner for the Nissan Grand Prix of Texas presented by Motul. Second place to Andrew Aquilani, third place Dean Martin. And there's, look at that, already doing the victory donuts in turn number one. Well, thank you for sticking with us here at WorldChallengeTV.com. For Jeremy Shaw, I'm Jeff Lepper. We'll see everybody again back here for the GT race.